Nicole or Rory's blood? Nicole.
That's right. Okay. We'll pray for Rory and Nicole.
And the lockdown.
And the hospital.
At Longview Regional? Wow, that's crazy.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Okay. What was her name? Amber. Yeah. Good. Awesome. All right. Go on. Yes, ma'am. Who's that? Wellman. That was Christy in the car wreck. Oh, Misty. Okay. Hey, I got Misty's dad, honey. Sorry, I can't. My hearing's a little bit pretty. It's okay, but it ain't great. All right. So pray for the Wellman family. All right. Yes, Dale. Schneider. Okay. Pray for the Schneider family.
Joanna and Little Butterfly.
Okay. All right. Yes, Miss Sherry. Darlene. Okay. Jimmy and Bob Fears?
Fears.
Barbara.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Awesome.
There you go.
So I still look the same. Or? Yes, ma'am. Awesome. Awesome. Awesome.
She's what?
What'd you say? Oh, she is. That's why she got that hat on. I like that hat. COVID queen. That's awesome news. Who else we got? Thank you, Eric. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am. For sure. Absolutely. Anybody else? All right, going once, going twice. Let's go ahead and pray. Lord, we just thank you for being awesome, God, Lord, and just thank you for all the blessings that you give us, Lord, and thank you for your church, Lord, that we get to come here and get together and eat and fellowship, Lord, and to talk and love each other and to lift each other up. And Lord, we just ask that you lift all these prayer requests up that you just heard. Lord, you're in complete control. Sometimes we don't understand why things happen like they do, but later on we'll understand it all, Lord. And we just thank you for just everything you do, Lord. Thank you for your son and what he did for us, Lord. And forgive us where we fail you. In Jesus' name, amen.
It's good to see everybody here tonight. He just said, well, how does this song go?
And he's the one singing.
Yeah.
Well, I guess I'm.
There it is.
Our God.
y'all know this one. We want to hear y'all sing it.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills, and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ.
Dean is our drum section tonight.
Thank you.
Y'all singing another one?
No, sir. We're waiting on you.
Hey, you can. You can sing a couple more if you like. That last song, does that remind you of the Lord being the king of your life? How's everybody this morning? You know, it may be morning by the time I get to bed. I don't know. I'm going to sit. I was having kind of a hard time coming up with the heading on this. Keep on keeping on. And I'm going to have to read some of this because, you know, as I get older, my memory is not as good. And plus, I've got a good excuse. Because I'm trying some new glasses, and they've got the line bifocal, and I've never had line bifocal, so in order to really try them out, I'm going to have to be able to read a lot. So that's what I'm going to try to do. I'll read some of it. I didn't have a whole lot of time. And Melly always tells me to talk fast. She does. I get up here and talk. She says, you talk too slow. You need to speed it up, talk faster. But it's kind of hard to get a 5-minute message to last 30 minutes. Isn't it, Dale? So that's what I'm trying to do, get a 5-minute message to last 30 minutes. How much time we got? Well, like I say, as I get older, and I'm sure a lot of us feel that way, that, you know, my time on this earth gets shorter. You know, there's a lot of things I have done in my life, some good, some bad. Some things I want to do, some things I don't. Sometimes this is one of them. But, you know, when I do it, I'm glad. Even though I don't know what I'm doing lots of times. There's some things I have seen, and there's some things I wished I wouldn't have seen. Some things I haven't seen, there's some things I wished I could see. Does this seem like some of y'all? It's me, I know. Because I go through life every day seeing things I wished I wouldn't have seen. Hearing things I wished I wouldn't have heard. And one of them was, you know, yesterday. You know, there's a lot of things we will see, we will hear, we'll be part of, we'll be not part of. But whatever it is I feel like maybe would be a blessing, I'm going to try to do that all the time. I don't always get it done, but I'm kind of like Mikey on that life cereal. I'll try anything, and I have. I remember one time Delia brought some kind of drink. Look, yucky. I don't know what it was. It was green, and we was over Lansing Switch. So I thought, oh, I'll drink it. So I got up front of everybody, I drank it. It was good. And I think, Sherry, did you bring some, did you make some dog biscuits? And she brought one of them. I know, but I ate it. I got up there and said, hey, these dog biscuits, I'm going to try it. And it was pretty good. So, you know, I'll try anything. And, you know, I don't know where this is coming from, but I guess when I was younger, I felt like, well, hey, I'll try Jesus. And you know what? I'm glad I did. There are a lot of things that we try. A lot of things we don't try. A lot of things we don't try, we may have should have tried. We won't know until we try. That makes sense. But if you look in Romans 7, 15, 20, this is Paul speaking. I don't really understand myself, for I want to do what is right, but I don't do it. Instead, I do what I hate. But if I know that what I am doing is wrong, this shows that I agree that the law is good. Got 18? And I know that nothing good lives in me, that is, in my sinful nature. I want to do what is right, but I can't. 19. I want to do what is good, but I don't. I don't want to do what is wrong, but I do it anyway. But if I do what I don't want to do, I am not really the one doing. It is sin living in me that does it. You know, a lot of times that's kind of hard to understand what he's saying. You know, I want to do right, and I think I'm doing right, but I'm not doing right. But why aren't I doing right? You know, I think a lot of times that rightness comes from here. You've got the Lord in your life. You know, I know right from wrong. But I still do wrong. That's just the sinful nature we have. Don't know why we do it. Don't know why I do it. I can't say I don't know why you do it because I don't know you do it. You know, and like I say, I don't know where a lot of this is going. We may get off chasing some rabbits a little bit. Of course, I like rabbits. But, you know, I lost my mother August 24th, 1958. I was 5 years old. I don't know why. I don't know why things happen. And why they happen when they do. None of us do. I just know that God is in control of all things. And I don't have to accept it. But I do. Because he is in control. You know, and I kind of get aggravated a lot of times when people say, well, are you saving these movie stars? You know, I don't believe in God, all that stuff. Fictional, it's, you know, none of it's true. It's somebody just came up with that. How do you come to something that is that perfect. I mean, Hollywood has all these movies they try to come up with. You know, at least we don't have all the language. We don't have all the immoral activities. Well, there were some, I think, in the Bible, but we don't have all that in the Bible that we can read, and we can read something clean. We can hear about something clean instead of watching all this crap on TV. And that's what I call it, crap. But have you noticed a lot of what I have used is the word I in me when I was talking about I don't like this, I don't like that. There's a lot of things I use a lot of I. But you know, it's not about me. It's not about I. It's all about God and I for me. I wasn't too good in English, so I don't know how, if I use God and I or God and me or me and God or God and I. I wasn't much in school. And I know there's some teachers in here. Wasn't my teacher's fault. I did get a few licks for not doing the grades I should have gotten, but that may be what's wrong with today's world. They don't know what licks are. And I'm talking slow, Melody. Trying to get a 5-minute message into 30 minutes. And I hope you're getting something. Because I did, even kind of doing this, realizing who I am and what I am and what I should be and what I shouldn't be. But you know, I can tell you about all the things that I have been through in my life. Tell you about all the bad. So maybe I could get a little sympathy. Or, oh, that poor thing. You know, he sure had a rough childhood. He sure had a rough life. That boy's been through a lot. But you know, I'm not going to go into all that, because that's in the past. That is in the past. I've got to keep on keeping on. I'm trying to remember, but I don't remember the scripture, Dale May. I didn't even write it down. It just popped in my head. When God told this guy followed me, and he said, I can't. I got to bury my dad. Now, I'm not sure his dad was dead yet. He was just waiting on him to die because he wanted his money. He wanted that inheritance. And I think it went, let the dead bury the dead. So when we, you know, you've got to keep on keeping on. Forget that. You know, I don't know if I would have really wanted to inherit money if it was going to be under those conditions. Of course, it wouldn't have mattered. I didn't inherit nothing anyway. Don't expect to. And the only way I'd ever get anything is if I buy a lottery ticket. I don't do that. But, you know, we could talk and about our lives and what we've been through and, you know, oh, have pity on me. Look what I've been. You know, I got Jesus in my life. I don't have to worry about the past. I don't have to worry about what I went through, what I lived through. I just have to worry about how I'm going to move forward and who I'm going to move forward with. I think, too, I'm going to have to learn how to read my own writing. But, you know, this next little bit is going to be but it's not just I. Taken from and brought to. I've got number 6:24:26, but I'm not sure in my notes where it's supposed to be now or a little later on. Anyway, I'm going to tell you what God has done and doing in my life instead of what I guess it was partially Satan's fault. I don't know. But I know I had God in my life even back then, but I'm going to tell you some of the good things he's done. From birth until Melody. He blessed me, gave me my sweet, lovely, gorgeous, beautiful, will do anything for me, my wife, Melody Lynn Shirley. He blessed me with her. Next June be 50 years. I think he really blessed her for putting up with me. Maybe that's the way it needs to be. But you know, we've tried to serve, tried to, you know, live a good life, and we have. We didn't sin much. The only time we sinned was when she got me into sinning. I try to be good. But I tell you what, one thing she does now, she sleeps with me, she sleeps with the dog, and she sleeps with a potato. Now everybody knows what a potato's for, don't you? It works. It works. Cramps in your legs. I mean, she won't go to bed at night now. She said, where's my potato? She don't say, where's my husband? She said, where's my potato? But it works. And I can't remember. I think Sean maybe told us that. But, and if everybody finds that out, potatoes are going to go higher than they are now. Yeah. He also blessed and gave me a son, Michael Ryan Shirley. And we've been blessed because, you know, they live right across the pond from us. About maybe from here to that back wall. He also blessed and gave me wonderful daughter-in-law, Sheena Shirley. I can't remember her middle name because I don't ever call her that, but it's Sheena. Good mother, good daughter-in-law. She'll do anything Melly wants her to do. It's different when I ask. No, she would. She'd do anything that I would have her to do. You know, he gave me, blessed me with granddaughter, the first one. Brooklyn, Taylor, Shirley. And a lot of times she'll tell everybody when they've got company over, she'll come grab a hold of me and hug me back and say, Papa, said, you know, me and you are the sweetest ones in the family. I said, yeah, you're right, Brooklyn, we are. We are. But what's a blessing about her is she knows who Jesus Christ is. He's the Lord and Savior of her life. Now, a lot of times with being teenagers, they don't act like it. But we know that she knows that he's in her life. He also gave and blessed me with my granddaughter. Well, they call her Jillian Grace Shirley, but I call her Gigi. And I gave her that name because when Brooklyn was born, I wanted her to name Brooklyn Addison. See, I liked that name. Well, came out Brooklyn. She said, well, if we have another, I promise I'll name her Addison. They had the second one, Jillian Grace. That's all right. That's cool. I'm going to call her Gigi for her initials. And I do, and she answers to it, and every once in a while they'll slip and call her Gigi. But, you know, he's blessed me with a lot. He also gave and blessed me being a partner with Mickey for 30 years. You know, a lot of people thought me and him were brothers. They said, that's your brother? I said, no, I'd call worse than him being my brother. But he was a blessing. You know, we worked together 30 years. Yeah, we'd get in fights. We'd never fist fights. But we'd get in a little squabble. We'd get in, you know, not liking this, not liking that. And 5 minutes later, we was over it. We'd get a truck, run down the store, get us a candy bar or a bottle of pop. I bet a lot of people don't know what a bottle of pop is. Soda pop. But, you know, we were blessed. And everybody said, how did y'all manage to stay partners that long? I said, for one thing, we knew who was the boss. God was our boss. He made sure what we did it right. We did it honest, and we did it with hard work. Plus, I would tell people, well, I just let him think he's the boss and everything. Works fine. Neither one of us is really the boss, but I let him be the boss, and he's happy. Oh, he knows. I've told him. I said, hey, I've told people, Mickey, me and you got along because I let you think you're the boss. He said, well, you know, I did the same thing with you. Let him think you're the boss. So we got along. But, you know, he also gave and blessed me being able to retire. I don't know if a lot of y'all know, but I'm retired. Or I don't work and get paid. I work, but I don't get paid. He also gave and blessed me being able to serve here at Trails End Cowboy Church. And I know there's a lot of people come and gone over the years. But until you have the opportunity to be part of this fellowship, step up, serve. You're not serving me. You're not serving each other, we're serving God. And it just, if you ain't ever served God, you ain't ever got the excitement, the joy in your heart like those of us, I'm sure, that have. You know, there's lots of Wednesday nights I wouldn't want to come to church. But you know why I come? I don't want to miss nothing. I don't want to miss the good meal we have. I don't want to miss the good message that Sean gives. I don't want to miss if somebody trips and falls and busts their head open. You know, I don't want to miss. I'm afraid I'm going to miss something if I'm not here. I don't want to miss the good music. I don't want to miss maybe somebody tripping and falling off the stage. I want to be here to serve and to not miss nothing. But you know, and I'm saying he gave and blessed me, but this is everybody, with a great pastor, this church, Sean Rhodes. I don't know how things would have turned out, but you know, we always say that nothing happens by accident. Dale didn't come over there by accident. Cindy didn't come here by accident. These two yahoos right here ran in Vaughn. They didn't come here by accident. God had you to come. He had a purpose. Larry and Barb, look how far they came. We got some people here from California. How far did you have to come? And it's Judy. So he doesn't send people here by accident. No, when you get here, you may leave by accident. Because maybe you know, a lot of times I thank God for sending you to a church, see if you fit in. I don't know if I fit in, but I'm still here. But, you know, we're blessed to have a preacher that we have that can get up here and preach Sunday and Wednesday. And I know he has to miss because of his wife and in different circumstances. You know, he's got a big family, and they have a lot of stuff happening a lot of times. Well, he wants to have those memories. He wants to seize that moment, and that's what we all ought to do when we have opportunities to be part of something or be involved in something, to seize that moment. And that kind of makes me think of another I read, and I don't think it's one of these scriptures, but it's when the blind man was sitting at the entrance, at the gate, I think, and every day he would be there, I need help. But one day Jesus come by and he hollered out help. He got the help. He seized the moment. He could have waited, or he could have not done it right then. He could say, well, I'm going to tell him. But he sees the moment. And I read a little documentary or on that, or whatever you call those. And that's what he said. He said he did not put it off. He did it right then. He seized the moment, and he was healed. And I think a lot of times if we seize the moment of whatever the opportunity is that comes in front of us, we're part of that, and we seize that moment, it may change things. And he blessed me with his church family. You know, this is my family. And y'all not just individuals sitting out here, even though I can't remember everybody's name, but you're still my cuz. That's what we usually do. For camp. Hey, cuz, how you doing? But you know, you are my family, and I am blessed. God has blessed me so much through the years. That's one reason why I keep on keeping on, because I'm wanting to see what other things he blesses me with. I know Dale and Dalia. You know, they got a special heart place in my heart. I love him. I love Miss Teresa. We do that. I don't know if everybody used to watch The Little Rascals, but we do that. I've just been blessed. I know I've had a rough past, but I've had a better time from the time the Lord got a hold of me. And this is kind of how, I don't know if we had that other scripture, I don't see it in here, but I may have missed it. You get the picture. How if we do what the Lord wants us to do, yeah, that's it. So let's not get tired of doing what is good. At just the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessing if we don't give up. So we got to keep on keeping on. It's easy to give up. You know, I've had several of my nieces and nephews, sisters, all of them have been married and divorced. But they've asked me, how come you and Aunt Melody stay together so long? It's easy to quit. It's hard to put up with her. Now, I said, it's easy to quit, but you have to. I guess the reason why we stay together is because Jesus didn't want us to leave each other. We had God in our life. We had God in our hearts. We knew it wouldn't be right. And I couldn't make it. I couldn't make it without her. I'm giving her most of the credit for me. I love her dearly. I don't tell her. You know, I told her 50 years ago I loved her, and I mean it. I don't have to tell you every day. But the most important of all is God gave his son Jesus to me and to you. By accepting and receiving Jesus as our Lord and Savior, we do have a future. We can keep on keeping on in eternity. We will spend it with them. Let's pray. Father God, we just thank you. God, we just thank you so much for what you've done for us and what you keep doing for us. God, we don't deserve anything from you or from anybody. We don't deserve it. But with your love, your grace, and your mercy, you give us what you give us. And the most you gave us was your son. So God, I just thank you for blessing me, blessing this church, We ask you to continue to bless Sean and his family. We just ask you to continue to bless our country, people in Israel. God, we just ask tonight that you just lay your hands upon Bob Southern. We know right now he's weak. He's been through this chemo. We've got word that he's just kind of down. So we just ask, Father, that you touch him. Just give him peace. Give him some strength. Just let him get back up into where he wants to be, and that's being in your house and serving you. Father, we just thank you for everything you do. We thank you for the season that we're fixing to celebrate, and that is the birth of our Lord and Savior. Be with us now as we go. Just let us be a light for you. Let us be obedient to what it is you have us to do. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.